Brothers and sisters in Christ, may the peace and grace of the Lord be with you. Let me read from a passage to encourage you. Psalms chapter 103, verse 2 to 5. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. He forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. I will lead us to say the opening prayer. Let's pray. O Lord, we praise you for the victory that comes through the death and resurrection of Jesus. Our Lord has risen from the dead and seated at your right hand, and he is above all powers, rulers, dominions, and spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Thank you that Christ is now both Lord and Savior, and he will return as Lord of Lords and King of Kings. He will destroy the evil one with the breath of his mouth and by the splendor of his coming. Lord, thank you for making us the body of Jesus. Thank you for anointing us and sealing us with the Holy Spirit, who guarantees our rich inheritance in you. To you belong all glory, power, and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We will now have a time of worship. Let's worship the Lord wholeheartedly. He loves us so wonderfully, and there's no reason why we should not worship him wholeheartedly.
I'm trading my sorrows.
I'm trading my sorrows. I'm trading my shame. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness. Trading my pain, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
We say yes, Lord.
We say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
I'm trading my sorrows.
I'm trading my sorrow. I'm trading my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
I'm trading my sickness.
I'm trading my sickness. I'm trading my pain.
I'm laying them down.
I'm laying them down. The joy of the Lord.
And we say yes, Lord.
We say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
We say yes, Lord.
We say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
I'm pressed but not crushed, persecuted not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I'm blessed beyond the curse, for his promise will endure. Joy's gonna be my strength.
Though the sorrow may last for the night, my joy comes in the morning. I'm trading my sorrow. I'm trading Lord.
I'm trading my sickness.
I'm trading my sickness. I'm trading my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Say yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen.
We say yes, Lord.
We say yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord, amen. Yes, yes, Lord, amen. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Father to the fatherless, defender of the weak, freedom for the prisoner, we sing. This is God in His holy place. This is God clothed in love and strength. Sing out, lift your voice and cry out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God. Sing out, raise your hands and shout out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God. Us in the wilderness, faithful to provide every breath and every step we see. This is God in His holy place. This is God clothed in love and strength. Lift your voice and cry out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God. Sing out, raise your hands and shout out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God. Father to the fatherless,
Father to the fatherless, defender of the weak, freedom for the prisoner, we sing. This is God in His holy place. This is God clothed in love. Sing out, lift your voice and cry out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God.
We sing out.
Sing out, raise your hands and shout out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God. Thank you.
greater, no, there is none stronger than our God. There is no higher, there is no higher, no, there is no greater, no, there is none stronger than our God. We sing, there is no higher, there is no higher, no, there is no greater, no, there is none stronger than our God. Lift your voice, sing out, lift your voice and cry out. Awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God.
Sing out,
sing out, raise your hands and shout out. Your awesome is our strong God, mighty is our God.
We are very pleased to have Pastor Robert Sasanka to speak to us today. He is a senior pastor of AFLAM Gospel Assembly in Kampala, Uganda. Last week, he came to Kuching to conduct two nights of healing services with us and one night of healing service in Sibuya. Here we will show some snapshots of the healing services in our church and in Sibuya.
Let's go to Exodus chapter 23, verse 25.
Hari ini kita akan melihat dalam Keluaran pasal 23 ayat 25.
Exodus 23, 25.
Keluaran 23, 25.
Praise the Lord. My sermon is health and healing.
Dan khotbah saya pada malam ini tentang penyembuhan dan kesembuhan.
So you shall serve the Lord your God.
Keluaran 23:25 mengatakan kamu harus menyembah Tuhan Allahmu.
And he will bless your bread and your water.
Dan dia akan memberkati air dan rotimu.
And I'll take sickness away from the midst of you.
Dan saya akan mengambil sakit itu daripada tengah-tengahmu.
No one shall suffer miscarriage or be barren in your land.
Tidak akan ada seseorang pun yang akan kehilangan bayinya ataupun tidak dapat melahirkan anak.
I will fulfill the number of your days.
Saya akan memenuhi hari-harimu.
The Lord says you shall serve him.
Tuhan Yesus mengatakan kamu harus melayani saya.
And he'll bless your bread and your water.
Dan dia akan memberkati roti dan airmu.
When you serve God,
bila kita melayani Tuhan,
he puts a blessing on your food.
Dia akan memberkati makanan kita.
And when your food is blessed,
dan apabila makanan kita diberkati,
that means that food can nourish your body.
Dan makanan itu boleh memberi kekuatan pada tubuh badan kita.
When your food is blessed,
dan apabila makanan kita diberkati,
now get New King James, get New King James, not NIV. When your food is blessed,
apabila makanan kita diberkati,
the Lord says, and I'll take away sickness from your midst.
Dan saya akan mengambil semua kesakitan daripada tengah-tengahmu.
This is talking about health.
Ini menyatakan tentang kesehatan.
If you're not sick, you're healthy.
Kalau kamu tidak sakit, kamu adalah sehat.
This is a healing meeting.
Dan ini adalah pertemuan penyembuhan.
But you need healing because you're sick.
Tapi kalau kamu tidak sakit, kamu tidak perlu penyembuhan.
But God says He will take away sickness from your midst.
Tapi Tuhan mengatakan Dia akan mengambil segala sakit penyakit dari antaramu.
From your home.
Daripada rumahmu.
He will take away sickness away from your children.
Dia akan mengambil sakit penyakit dari anak-anakmu.
He will take away sickness from your church.
Dia akan mengambil sakit penyakit dari orang
He
di bawahmu.
He will take away sickness from your city.
Dia akan mengambil sakit penyakit
no,
dari kotamu.
No, you are not hearing me. I said He will take away sickness from your city.
Dia akan mengambil sakit penyakit dari
Can
kotamu.
Can I hear a loudest amen?
Kita berkatakan dengan lebih dahsyat lagi.
He said, I'll take away sickness from your midst.
Dan Dia katakan, Aku akan mengambil sakit penyakit dari antaramu.
When COVID came,
apabila COVID datang,
it was sickness in the midst of every city and every nation.
Ada sakit di antara semua bangsa di dunia.
Instead of taking away the sickness,
selain daripada mengambil sakit penyakit itu,
they were taking away the sick.
Dan mereka mengatakan kepada orang yang sakit,
called quarantine.
Dan kamu di dalam quarantine.
So they take away the sick.
Dan mereka mengambil orang yang sakit
But
itu.
But God doesn't want to take away the sick.
Tapi Tuhan tidak ingin mengambil orang
He
yang sakit.
He wants to take away sickness.
Tapi Dia ingin mengambil kesakitan
Because
itu.
Because divine health is His plan.
Karena kesehatan ilahi adalah rencana Tuhan.
And you shall serve the Lord your God.
Dan kamu perlu menyembah Tuhan Allahmu.
And shall bless thy bread and thy water.
Dan saya akan memberkati roti dan airmu.
And I'll take sickness away from the midst of thee.
Dan saya akan mengambil kesakitan dari antaramu.
There are families where there's so much sickness.
Di dalam dunia ini sekarang banyak sangat sakit penyakit.
When one member is getting healed, another one is falling sick.
Apabila seorang itu disembuhkan, ada pula yang lain yang jatuh sakit.
There are cities where many people are sick.
Di mana banyak kota-kota di mana ramai orang yang sakit.
There are nations where people are sick.
Di mana negara-negara di mana orang-orangnya sakit.
But that is not the plan of God.
Tapi itu bukanlah rencana Tuhan.
He said when you serve Him.
Dia berkata apabila kamu melayani Dia.
He will keep you in divine health.
Dia akan memegang kamu dalam kesehatan yang ilahi.
The problem is many of His children don't serve Him.
Masalahnya ramai anak-anak Tuhan sekarang tidak melayani Tuhan.
We have many pew warmers and fewer ministers in churches.
Dan sekarang kita mempunyai kekurangan pelayan-pelayan dalam gereja.
But serving God has a benefit.
Tapi melayani Tuhan itu ada kebaikannya.
Because God is looking for those who will serve Him.
Karena Tuhan mencari orang yang melayani Dia.
You are either serving God.
Kalau kamu melayani Tuhan.
Or serving yourself.
Ataupun melayani kamu sendiri.
Or serving your stomach.
Atau melayani perut kamu.
But this is a promise for divine health.
Tapi ini adalah janji kesehatan yang ilahi.
You shall serve the Lord your God.
Kamu perlu melayani Tuhan
Then
Allahmu.
He will take away sickness from your midst.
Dan Dia akan mengambil sakit penyakit dari antara kamu.
If you're here and you're serving God.
Dan jika kamu di sini kamu melayani Tuhan.
Divine health is your portion.
Kesehatan ilahi itu untuk kamu.
I say divine health is your portion.
Kesehatan ilahi itu adalah untuk kamu.
God is able to take away sickness from your family.
Karena Tuhan itu dapat mengambil segala sakit penyakit daripada keluargamu.
From big sicknesses to small ones.
Daripada sakit yang besar sampai sakit yang kecil.
You can live a healthy life.
Kan kamu boleh hidup dalam hidup yang sehat.
Without flu, without cough.
Tanpa ada flu ataupun batuk.
Without headache, without pain.
Tanpa sakit kepala ataupun sakit badan.
That's what God's word says.
Itulah yang dikatakan Tuhan kepadamu.
If it wasn't possible.
Kalau itu tidak mustahil mungkin.
This will be a lie.
Maka ayat ini adalah satu dusta.
You see many people today they say but I'm not sure because I see many sick.
Kadang-kadang banyak orang mengatakan saya tidak pasti karena saya selalu sakit.
And they say I also see people serving God but they are sick.
Dan dia mengatakan saya sebenarnya ingin melayani Tuhan tapi saya sakit.
The Bible says my people perish for lack of knowledge.
Dan firman Tuhan mengatakan umatku musnah karena mereka hilang tidak ada pengetahuan.
You don't interpret God's word.
Kalau kita tidak menginterpretasikan firman Tuhan
through your experiences,
melalui pengalaman kita,
you align your experiences,
kamu menyatakan pengalaman kamu
with
itu
God's word.
Dengan firman Tuhan.
If you find you're not experiencing what the Bible says,
tapi kalau kamu mencari pengalaman kamu melalui firman Tuhan,
seek knowledge,
carilah pengetahuan itu,
receive understanding,
terimalah pengetahuan itu,
to find out what is that you are not doing,
untuk mencari apa yang kita tidak lakukan. lakukan.
Sometimes you're doing everything right and well.
Kadang-kadang kita rasa kita melakukan segala sesuatu dengan betul.
But you're lacking one major thing.
Tapi kita kehilangan satu perkara.
It is called faith.
Yaitu iman.
You don't expect the results the Bible says.
Karena kita tidak mengharapkan apa yang firman Tuhan katakan.
You don't exercise your faith according to God's word.
Dan kita tidak melakukan iman itu sesuai dengan firman Tuhan.
And it becomes hard and difficult for you to experience the blessing of the word.
Maka itu menjadikan kita amat sukar untuk mengalami berkat Tuhan.
I want to tell you something.
Saya ingin katakan sesuatu.
This is the absolute truth.
Ini adalah kebenaran yang betul.
My children, my daughter is 18 years old.
Anak perempuan saya berusia 18 tahun.
But she likes telling people, even in church.
Tapi dia suka menyatakan orang terutama di gereja.
I have never seen my father sick.
Dan saya tidak pernah melihat ayah saya sakit.
And that is the truth.
Dan itulah kebenarannya.
Yes, clap your hands to Jesus. That is the truth.
Itulah kebenarannya.
I believe God's word.
Karena saya percayakan firman Tuhan.
I have been serving God for the last 25 years fully.
Dan saya telah melayani Tuhan secara penuhnya selama 25 tahun.
If God has given me this scripture.
Karena Tuhan memberikan saya ayat ini.
That is his plan for me.
Itulah rencananya bagi saya.
Now that doesn't mean that sickness has not attacked me sometimes.
Itu tidak berarti bahwa kesakitan itu menyerang saya kadang-kadang.
But I have stood on this scripture and have refused sickness from coming into my body.
Tapi saya berdiri teguh atas firman Tuhan ini menyatakan kesakitan itu tidak dapat menyentuh tubuh badan
saya.
That
is called divine health.
Dan itu yang dinyatakan kesehatan
ilahi. I will take away sickness from your midst.
Dan saya akan mengambil kesakitan itu dari antaramu.
I like New King James. He said, "None of you shall miscarry or be barren."
Tapi dalam ini dia mengatakan tidak akan ada yang keguguran ataupun yang mandul.
None of you shall miscarry or be barren.
Dan ataupun keguguran ataupun mandul
in your land,
di dalam di atas tanahmu,
and the number of your days,
dan hari-harimu,
I will fulfill,
akan ku penuhi.
No premature death,
tidak ada kematian yang sepramatang.
No barrenness,
tidak ada.
No miscarriage,
tidak ada keguguran dan mandul.
Come on, hallelujah.
Kita katakan
I
hallelujah.
I say no premature death,
tidak ada kematian pramatang.
He said the number of your days I shall fulfill,
dan dia katakan hari-harimu akan kupenuhi.
Do you know you have days you're supposed to be alive?
Ataukah kita hari-hari kita harusnya dipenuhi dengan kehidupan?
You're not supposed to die before your time.
Kita tidak sepatutnya mati sebelum masanya.
And the Bible shows us days.
Dan Tuhan firman Tuhan menyatakan kita hari-harinya.
It shows us the years we should live.
Dan dia mengatakan hanya untuk Yesus kita hidup.
Do you want to know the years?
Oh, kita tahu berapa tahun kita
I'm
perlu
asking,
hidup?
Do you want to know the years?
Adakah kita tahu berapa tahun kita mau hidup?
Come tomorrow morning.
Datang esok pagi.
Yes, I'm not telling you tomorrow morning I will.
Esok pagi saya akan katakan itu.
So the Bible
itu.
Says the number of your days the Lord shall fulfill.
Dan firman Tuhan katakan hari-harimu akan kupenuhi.
When sickness comes it wants to cut short people's lifespan.
Apabila kesakitan datang dia ingin memendekkan umur hayat kita.
Premature death attacks people.
Dan kematian sepramatang itu menyerang manusia.
Through sickness.
Dia akan beri kesakitan.
But the Bible tells us no.
Tapi firman Tuhan mengatakan itu adalah tidak.
We shouldn't allow it.
Kita tidak harus membenarkan itu.
The Lord has promised us.
Karena Tuhan sudah
die in full age.
Menjanjikan kita akan mati bila tiba waktunya.
You're not supposed to die before you fulfill God's plan for your life.
Kita tidak sepatutnya mati sebelum kita melakukan rencana Tuhan dalam kehidupan kita.
The Bible says with long life I shall satisfy you.
Dan firman Tuhan mengatakan saya akan beri kamu umur yang panjang.
If you're not yet satisfied.
Kalau kamu belum dipenuhi
with life,
dengan kehidupan,
a fruitful life,
dengan kehidupan yang berkelimpahan,
a purposeful life,
dengan kehidupan yang penuh dengan tujuan,
life,
dengan tujuan yang sudah ada impact,
you are not ready to die.
Kamu belum lagi bersedia untuk
I say
mati.
Not ready to die.
Kamu belum bersedia
you're
untuk mati.
You're not hearing me. I say you will not die before your time.
Kita tidak akan mati sebelum waktunya.
18 years ago.
18 tahun yang lalu.
In fact, there should be 19.
Mungkin 19 tahun.
My wife was expecting our firstborn, who is our daughter.
Dan istri saya mengandung anak perempuan kami yang pertama.
And she had a threatening miscarriage at 3 months.
Dan dia merasakan ada kemungkinan keguguran untuk 3 bulan.
I stood on this scripture.
Dan saya berdiri di atas firman Tuhan ini.
I said, God, you said.
Dan saya mengatakan, Tuhan, Engkau mengatakan.
None of us shall miscarry.
Tidak ada antara kami yang akan keguguran.
None of us shall be barren.
Tidak ada antara kami yang akan menjadi mandul.
I refuse miscarriage in my family.
Dan saya menolak keguguran ini dalam keluargaku.
So when she reached 7 months.
Dan apabila dia tiba 7 bulan.
The midwife, it wasn't the midwife, the gynecologist, the top doctor.
Dan dokter perempuan itu
advised me.
Memberi saya nasihat.
She told me you're going to lose your wife and that baby.
Dia mengatakan kepada saya, saya akan kehilangan istri dan anak saya.
If we don't terminate the pregnancy.
Kalau saya tidak memberhentikan kehamilan itu.
And she told me you choose what you want.
Dan dia kata kamu pilih mana satu yang kamu mau.
I told her no terminating the pregnancy.
Dan saya katakan saya tidak akan memberhentikan kehamilan ini.
I will not lose my wife.
Saya tidak akan hilang istri saya.
I will not lose my baby.
Dan saya tidak akan hilang bayi saya itu.
Now she didn't know who I was.
Karena dia tidak tahu siapa saya.
I told her I'm a pastor.
Dan saya kata kepada dia saya seorang pastor.
I believe in God's word.
Dan saya percaya dengan
and
firman
God's
Tuhan.
God's word will prove me right.
Dan firman Tuhan itu akan adalah kebenaran.
She gave me a serious look.
Dan dia melihat saya secara serius.
And she told me, "Are you sure?"
Dan saya kata dia katakan kepada saya, "Adakah kamu
said,
pasti?"
Yes, I am.
Dan saya katakan ya.
So we left the place.
Dan kami tinggalkan tempat itu.
She had given us lot of negative bad news.
Dan dia memberikan kami negatif berita yang tidak baik.
Including saying that in case she manages to give birth.
Dan dia katakan jika ada kemungkinan dia ingin melahirkan.
She'll give birth to an abnormal baby.
Dia akan melahirkan seorang anak yang abnormal.
Maybe some limbs are not there.
Mungkin ada tangan yang tidak ada di sana.
Maybe a baby who can't understand.
Mungkin seorang bayi yang tidak boleh mengerti.
I told this lady no.
Dan saya kata kepada perempuan ini tidak.
She's a professional.
Dia seorang profesional.
I'm also a professional.
Dan saya juga seorang profesional.
She's a medical professional.
Dia adalah seorang medical professional.
I'm a word professional.
Dan saya adalah firman Tuhan
I
professional.
Said no.
Dan saya katakan tidak.
So when we left.
Dan apabila kami
my wife was crying.
Istri saya menangis.
I'm teaching about divine health right now.
Dan saya mengatakan tentang
because
kesehatan
it was
ilahi.
Too much pain in her body.
Karena dia merasakan kesakitan dalam tubuh
and
badan
too
dia.
Too much negative news she had just heard.
Dan banyak kabar-kabar yang negatif yang sudah didengarnya.
So we sat down.
Dan kami duduk.
I opened my Bible.
Dan saya buka firman Tuhan.
I took her to this scripture.
Dan saya membaca firman Tuhan
I
ini.
I took her to another scripture in Isaiah 65:27.
Dan saya membaca dalam Yesaya 65:27.
And I told her, listen.
Dan saya mengatakan
those
kepada dia.
Are the words of the doctor.
Itu adalah perkataan dari dokter.
But these are the words of God.
Tapi ini adalah perkataan Tuhan.
You shall not miscarry.
Kamu tidak akan keguguran.
You shall give birth to a normal child.
Kamu akan melahirkan anak yang sempurna.
And the number of our days the Lord shall fulfill.
Dan hari-hari kita akan dipenuhi.
When the time to give birth came.
Dan apabila tiba masanya dia melahirkan.
It took her only 3 hours.
Dia hanya mengambil 3 jam sahaja.
And she gave birth to the most beautiful, healthy baby who's right now 18 years old.
Dan dia melahirkan seorang anak yang sempurna yang sekarang berumur 18
tahun. The word
tahun.
Of God prevailed.
Dan firman Tuhan itu telah menyatakan kebenarannya.
Do not think you can enjoy divine health.
Jangan fikir kita tidak boleh mengalami keindahan kesehatan ilahi.
Outside the word of God.
Dari di luar firman Tuhan.
The word of God is your vitamin.
Karena firman Tuhan ini adalah vitamin kita.
Every morning taking the word.
Setiap pagi kita ambil firman Tuhan.
Every morning speak the word.
Setiap pagi kita nyatakan firman Tuhan
because
itu.
Because the word is medicine.
Karena firman Tuhan itu adalah obat.
Give me Proverbs chapter 4 verse 20. Proverbs 4:20.
Beri saya Amsal 20:20.
By the time we are done today here.
Apabila kita berakhir pada malam
you're
ini.
You're going to know how to live a healthy life.
Kita akan tahu bagaimana hidup yang sehat.
God wants you well.
Karena Tuhan ingin kita sehat.
Tell your neighbor, God wants you well.
Tuhan ingin kita sehat.
He says, my son.
Dia katakan anakku.
Attend to my words.
Dengarlah perkataanku.
Incline thine ear unto my sayings.
Berilah telingamu kepada perkataanku.
Go to the next one, please. Let's keep going.
Seterusnya.
Sure? No, I want many. Do not let them depart from your eyes.
Jangan biarkan perkataan itu keluar daripada mulutmu.
Keep them in the midst of your heart.
Simpanlah itu di tengah-tengahmu.
For they are life to those who find them.
Karena itu merupakan hidup bagi mereka yang mencarinya.
And health to all their flesh.
Dan kesehatan untuk semua tubuh badan mereka.
No, verse 21. It's 23. Sorry. It is for their life 22. To those who find them and health to all their flesh.
Karena itu adalah hidup untuk mereka yang mencarinya dan kesehatan bagi semua tubuh
badan
mereka.
The word of God is health to your flesh.
Firman Tuhan itu adalah kesehatan untuk tubuh badan kita.
Divine health is your portion.
Kesehatan ilahi itu adalah milik kita.
How many of you want to live a healthy life? You don't want to visit a doctor this year. Let me see your hand. How many of you?
Kalau kita tidak ingin berjumpa dokter,
lift your hand and say, divine health.
Kesehatan ilahi
is my portion.
Adalah milik
say,
saya.
Say divine health.
Kesehatan ilahi
is my portion.
Adalah milik saya.
He says keep the word in your heart.
Dia katakan simpanlah perkataan itu dalam hatimu.
When you feel sickness attacking you.
Apabila kita merasa sakit itu menyerang kita.
Don't speak fear.
Jangan katakan ketakutan.
Don't speak doubt.
Jangan katakan
don't
keraguan.
Speak unbelief.
Jangan katakan ketidakpercayaan.
Speak the word of God.
Tapi katakan firman Tuhan.
He said if you serve him,
dan dia kata kalau kamu melayani
he'll
saya,
take away sickness from your midst.
Dia akan mengambil kesakitan itu dari antaramu.
I see many of you living a healthy life in the name of Jesus.
Dan saya katakan kita akan melayani hidup yang sehat dalam nama Tuhan
It
Yesus.
It doesn't matter the sickness around you.
Dia tidak inginkan sakit penyakit antara
you
kita.
You will be preserved.
Kita akan dipelihara.
Shout amen.
Katakan amen.
The second one is Jeremiah chapter 30 verse 17.
Seterusnya Yeremia.
Jeremiah 30 17.
Pasal 37 ayat 17.
Jeremiah 30:17.
Jeremiah 30:17.
For I'll restore health to you.
Saya akan memberi kamu kesehatan.
And heal you of your wounds.
Dan akan menyembuhkan lukamu.
Says the Lord.
Kata Tuhan.
Because they called you an outcast, saying.
Karena mereka yang memanggil kamu itu orang yang di
This is Zion and no one seeketh after her.
Dan ia adalah Zion karena tidak ada manusia yang akan mencari mereka.
The Bible says I'll restore health to you.
Dan firman Tuhan mengatakan saya akan memberikan semula kesehatan untukmu. Dan saya akan menyembuhkan luka-lukamu.
Healing is your portion.
Kesembuhan itu adalah milikmu.
Divine health, you're not sick.
Kesehatan ilahi itu adalah kita tidak
But
sakit.
But when you fall sick, God says He will restore health to you.
Tapi apabila kita jatuh sakit, Tuhan menyatakan Dia akan memberikan kehidupan yang sehat itu kembali
kepadamu.
Anytime
you find yourself sick,
dan setiap kali kita kita sakit,
you should expect healing.
Kita mesti mengharapkan kesembuhan.
Don't say.
Jangan katakan
the Lord heals sometimes.
Tuhan itu menyembuhkan kadang-kadang
and
saja.
And other times he doesn't heal.
Dan pada masa yang lain dia tidak menyembuhkan.
Don't allow your life.
Jangan benarkan kehidupan kamu.
To live according to the opinions of men.
Hidup sesuai dengan pendapat manusia.
God heals all the time.
Karena Tuhan menyembuhkan senantiasa.
I say God heals all the time.
Tuhan menyembuhkan senantiasa.
So when you find yourself sick.
Dan apabila kita merasa sakit.
Don't be ashamed.
Jangan kita malu.
Don't be shy.
Jangan kita malu.
Don't hide away.
Jangan kita bersembunyi.
Go to God with boldness.
Pergi kepada Tuhan dengan keberanian.
God will restore health to you.
Dia akan memberikan kesehatan semula kepada
kita. He will give you back that feeling of wellness in your body.
Dia akan memberikan perasaan rasa baik itu kembali kepada tubuh badan
kita. He will take away pain.
Dia akan mengambil kesakitan.
He will take away stress.
Dia akan mengambil itu stres.
And he will heal all your wounds.
Dia akan menyembuhkan segala luka-luka kita.
The reason I pray for the sick.
Dan apabila saya berdoa untuk orang sakit,
with all boldness,
dengan keberanian,
because I believe and I know,
karena saya tahu dan mereka percaya,
this is the will of God.
Ini adalah kehendak Tuhan.
Jesus said,
Yesus mengatakan,
healing is the children's bread.
Bahwa penyembuhannya, kesembuhan itu adalah roti anak-anaknya.
It doesn't cost him anything to heal you.
Dia tidak akan itu dia berinya secara percuma.
He doesn't need days to heal you.
Dia tidak mengambil banyak hari untuk menyembuhkan kamu.
He heals you instantly.
Dia akan menyembuhkan kamu pada saat itu juga.
He heals you immediately.
Dia akan menyembuhkan kamu pada saat itu juga.
The manifestation might not be seen immediately.
Mungkin kita tidak melihat manifestasi itu
but
secara.
But the healing has taken place immediately.
Tetapi kesembuhan itu berlaku secara semerta-merta.
I want to teach you this. Hear me. If you get this, you will never ever miss your healing.
Dan saya ingin kamu mendengar ini dan kalau kamu faham ini, kamu tidak akan kehilangan kesembuhan itu.
Why people say that God sometimes doesn't heal?
Mengapakah orang ada mengatakan kadang-kadang Tuhan itu tidak menyembuhkan?
And others say he heals gradually.
Dan ada orang yang mengatakan dia memberi kesembuhan itu secara perlahan.
It's because they're confusing the healing and the manifestation.
Karena mereka keliru dengan kesembuhan itu dan manifestasinya.
Let me begin with sickness.
Dan Tuhan itu, mari kita
katakan sickness kesakitan. Has symptoms. Is that not so?
Kesakitan itu ada simptom-simptomnya.
So when you talk about the symptoms,
apabila kita berkata tentang simptom itu,
the doctor will know the disease.
Dan dokter itu akan tahu apakah penyakitnya.
Sometimes you go to the doctor and you tell them you're sick.
Kadang-kadang kita pergi ke dokter mengatakan kita sakit.
But you're telling them symptoms.
Dan tapi kita tahu apa simptomnya.
An example can say I have migraine headache.
Dan kadang-kadang kita katakan saya ada sakit kepala.
But yet the doctor knows you are not suffering from headache. It's a symptom.
Tapi dokter tahu kita bukan sakit kepala, itu adalah simptomnya.
But maybe you have hypertension.
Mungkin kita ada penyakit darah tinggi.
You could be sweating a lot.
Kalau kita berpeluh secara banyak.
But the doctor knows it's not the sweating, it's the palpitation of your heart.
Dan dokter itu tahu bukan sakitnya kamu berpeluh banyak, tapi karena hati kamu sangat cepat.
So symptoms are manifestation of a disease.
And symptom dan manifestasi penyakit itu.
Now healing also has manifestation.
Dan begitu juga kesembuhan ada manifestasinya.
But when are you healed?
Tapi apabila kamu disembuhkan?
Give me Mark chapter 11 verse 23.
Mari kita lihat Markus 11:23.
Mark 11:23.
Markus 11:23.
Today I want to teach you because I want you to stay with this and move with it.
Dan hari ini saya ingin mengajar kamu supaya kamu dapat mengertikan ini.
Mark 11:23-24.
Markus 11:23 hingga 24.
He said, "For verily I say unto you,
itu saya katakan kepadamu,
that whosoever shall say unto this mountain,
siapapun yang mengatakan kepada gunung
be
ini,
thou removed and be thou cast into the sea,
gunung ini akan dipindahkan dan dibuang ke dalam laut,
and shall not doubt in his heart,
tidak ada keraguan dalam hatinya,
but shall believe that all things which he saith shall come to pass,
tapi percaya dalam hatinya bahwa perkara itu boleh terjadi,
he shall have whatsoever he saith."
Dia akan menerima apapun yang telah dikatakannya.
If you have faith,
kalau kamu punya iman,
you shall say to this mountain of sickness,
kamu boleh berkatakan kepada gunung penyakit
you
ini,
you shall say to this mountain of symptoms,
dan kamu boleh mengatakan kepada gunung simptom ini,
you shall say to this mountain of pain,
kamu boleh mengatakan pada gunung kesakitan,
you shall say to this mountain of paralysis,
kamu katakan kepada gunung kelumpuhan,
you shall say to this mountain of deafness and blindness,
kamu boleh katakan kepada gunung buta dan tuli,
be thou removed,
jika kamu akan dikeluarkan
and be cast into the sea,
dan dibuang ke dalam laut besar.
But when you say it,
tapi apabila kamu mengatakan
you should not
itu,
doubt in your heart,
kamu tidak keliru dalam hatimu,
but you should believe,
tapi kamu harus percaya,
that all things you have said,
segala apa yang kamu katakan
commanding
itu,
sickness to go,
yang kamu menyatakan kesakitan itu harus
that
pergi,
they shall come to pass,
itu akan terjadi,
then you shall have whatsoever you say,
dan kamu akan menerima apapun yang kamu katakan.
Look at 24.
Lihat ayat 24.
He said, "Therefore I say unto you,
oleh itu saya katakan kepadamu,
what things soever you desire when you pray,
apapun kehendak hatimu apabila kamu berdoa,
believe that you receive them,
percaya kamu sudah menerimanya,
and you shall have them,
dan kamu akan menerimanya."
Let me ask you, when do you believe?
Saya perkatakan bila kita percaya.
Talk to me, when do you believe?
Bila kita percaya.
I'm not hearing you. According to the scripture, when do you believe?
Menurut firman Tuhan ini, bilakah kita percaya?
Now look at the scripture, verse 24.
When we
pray. Let's read it together and be ready to answer. "Therefore I say unto you,
Karena itu saya katakan kepadamu.
What things soever you desire when you pray.
Apapun yang kamu kehendaki apabila kamu berdoa.
Believe that you receive them and you shall have them.
Percaya kamu sudah menerima dan kamu akan terimanya.
So according to that verse, when do you believe?
Dan menurut firman Tuhan ini bila kita percaya.
When do you believe? You got it right. Clap your hands for yourselves.
Beri tepukan untuk diri kita.
You believe when you pray.
Kita percaya bila kita berdoa.
As you're praying, you're believing.
Dan kita akan berdoa dan percaya.
When you pray, you're believing.
Masa kita berdoa, kita percaya.
You don't first wait to have them and you believe.
Kita tidak tunggu, kita terima, baru kita percaya.
So when healing is being ministered to you.
Dan apabila kesembuhan itu ada
when
atasmu.
When we pray, believe.
Bila kita berdoa, percaya.
At that moment.
And pada saat itu.
And say, then you shall have them.
Dan firman Tuhan katakan dan kamu akan menerimanya.
So healing takes place when we pray.
Oleh itu kesembuhan itu terjadi apabila kita berdoa.
Now what happens next is the manifestation of that healing.
Tapi apa yang kita tidak lihat adalah manifestasi kesembuhan itu.
It's the same when we pray.
Itu ada sama bila kita berdoa.
Many times we pray for things.
Banyak kali kita menganggap satu perkara berlaku.
We might not get them immediately physically.
Tapi kita tidak akan melihat itu secara serta merta secara fisikal.
But the Bible has told us at that moment we must believe.
Tapi firman Tuhan mengatakan pada saat itu kita mesti percaya kita sudah terima.
I think I've told you a story.
Saya ingin mengatakan satu cerita.
When I was in China.
Apabila saya di China.
Praying for people.
Berdoa untuk ramai orang.
That was 2010.
Itu pada tahun 2010.
And people are testifying.
Dan orang memberi kesaksian.
As they're testifying.
Apabila mereka bersaksi.
In the congregation there was a lady.
Ada seorang perempuan.
She had a back pain.
Dia ada sakit belakang.
So during the time of testimony.
Dan pada masa kesaksian itu.
She still had pain.
Dia masih ada sakit itu.
She was disappointed.
Dia rasa kecewa.
By those who are testifying.
Tapi ramai orang yang menyaksikan.
And she thought they were lying.
Dan dia mengatakan mungkin mereka berdusta.
Or she thought I was a fraud.
Dan ataupun dia berpikir saya orang seorang penipu.
Somehow I had planned with them to testify.
Dan dia kata mungkin saya membuat rencana untuk memberi kesaksian mereka
itu. You see,
itu.
If you are walking in the healing ministry, that always happens.
Apabila kamu dalam pelayanan kesembuhan itu selalu terjadi.
People who won't understand, people will say whatever they want to say.
Ada ramai orang yang tidak faham dan mereka akan mengatakan apa saja.
So when the meeting ended.
Dan apabila di akhir kebaktian itu.
At that time I don't know anything happening to this lady.
Pada masa itu saya tidak tahu apa yang terjadi pada perempuan ini.
So whatever I'm saying is part of her testimony.
Dan apapun yang saya katakan itu merupakan sebagian daripada kesaksian dia.
I told the congregation you are all healed.
Dan saya katakan kepada orang di ramai sana kamu semua sudah disembuhkan.
And I said some of you you will notice you're healed as you go home.
Dan saya katakan ada antara kamu sempat kamu kembali nanti kamu rasakan kamu sudah
some
disembuhkan.
Some of you when you wake up tomorrow you'll find the disease is gone.
Dan ada antara kamu esok pagi apabila kamu bangun kamu rasa sudah disembuhkan.
At that time she was still annoyed and angry.
Dan pada masa itu dia masih lagi marah.
And then I gave them an instruction.
Dan saya memberi mereka arahan.
I said when you go home.
Dan saya katakan pada tiba di rumah.
If you have anyone sick there.
Dan jika ada orang sakit di sana.
Lay hands on that person.
Tupang tangan kamu dengan orang itu.
That person will be healed.
Orang itu juga akan disembuhkan.
So all the way home she was complaining, arguing and angry.
Dan perempuan ini dalam perjalanan dia pulang dia masih lagi marah.
When she reached home.
Dan apabila dia tiba di rumah.
She remembered that instruction.
Dia ingat arahan itu.
She said her husband also had a severe backache.
Dan suaminya juga ada kesakitan belakang.
So she said, let me just try out what we were told.
Dan dia kata, okay, mari saya coba apa yang sudah diberitahu.
So she went and laid hands on her husband.
Dan dia tumpangkan tangannya pada suaminya.
She told her husband, this is what we've been told in church today.
Dia katakan ini diberitahu pada kami di gereja.
So she laid hands on the husband.
Dia tumpangkan tangan pada suaminya.
Prayed for healing.
Berdoa untuk dia.
Immediately.
Secara serta merta.
Everyone say immediately.
Kita immediately.
The husband shouted.
Dan suaminya berteriak.
Because pain left him immediately.
Karena kesakitan telah meninggalkan dia secara serta merta.
When she looked at the husband and she was surprised.
Dan dia melihat kepada suaminya dan dia sangat terkejut.
She also noticed.
Dan dia juga merasa.
That her pain had also left.
Karena sakit belakangnya
come
juga
on,
sudah hilang.
Come on, clap your hands to Jesus.
Kita beri tepukan untuk Yesus.
So when she laid hands on the husband was healed immediately.
Karena dia tumpangkan tangan pada suaminya, suaminya di serta merta disembuhkan.
As she was amazed, she also found out that her healing manifested immediately.
Apabila dia dengan perasaan sungguh terkejut, dia juga sadar bahwa dia juga disembuhkan serta merta.
Now you ask yourself.
Sekarang kita tanyakan pada diri kita.
This man stayed home.
Lelaki ini tinggal di rumah.
He didn't hear the preaching.
Dia tidak mendengar firman Tuhan.
When she did what she was instructed to do.
Apabila perempuan ini melakukan seperti
for
yang diarahkan,
his healing took place or manifested immediately.
Dan untuk suaminya kesembuhan itu adalah serta merta.
Hers maybe took some 2 hours or 3.
Dan dia kesembuhannya pula mungkin 2-3 jam baru terjadi.
What was the difference?
Apakah perbezaannya?
Believe and manifestation.
Percaya dan manifestasinya.
Are you hearing me?
Ada kita mendengar.
I'm talking to you. Are you hearing me?
Ada kita mendengar.
Believing and manifestation.
Percaya dan manifestasi itu.
When I pray for you.
Apabila saya berdoa untuk kamu.
I'm not discouraged at all.
Saya tidak kecewa.
By the way you look or the way you live here.
Apabila melihat keadaan kamu meninggalkan tempat
because
ini.
Because I know beyond the shadow of doubt.
Karena saya tidak ada keraguan pun.
That you're healed.
Kamu sudah disembuhkan.
I said you are healed.
Kamu disembuhkan.
Because that's what the Bible says.
Karena apa firman Tuhan katakan.
How many of you have watched that testimony on video? You've watched the video.
Kita sudah melihat video itu tadi.
Let me see.
Angkat tangan kita.
Okay. I want you to explain to me how can someone thousands of miles away.
Bagaimana kamu boleh terangkan kepada saya beribu-ribu batu jauhnya
be healed
telah menyembuhkan
immediately
secara serta merta
from a coma that has taken 40 days.
Dari seorang lelaki dalam koma 40 hari.
You see when we are praying healing is not medicine. We are not just trying to encourage you to comfort you. No.
Karena kita berdoa untuk kesembuhan, kita bukan memberi kamu kata-kata yang baik saja.
This is miracle power.
Karena ini adalah kuasa mukjizat.
Miracle power never fails.
Dan kuasa dalam mukjizat Tuhan tidak pernah gagal.
Because Jesus is the same yesterday, today and forever.
Karena Yesus itu sama semalam, hari ini dan selama-lamanya.
This year we've so far had 2 miracle services in our church.
Dalam tahun ini kami ada kebaktian penyembuhan 2 kali di gereja kami.
The last one was on Easter.
Dan yang terakhir adalah pada waktu Easter.
It was called Resurrection Miracle Service.
Dan itu dikatakan kebaktian kebangkitan mukjizat Tuhan.
The miracles we've seen and continue to see are amazing.
Karena mukjizat yang kita lihat dan kita terus-terusan melihat adalah satu yang amat besar.
I have come to believe with all my heart.
Dan saya percaya itu dengan sepenuh hati saya.
That if people can believe.
Dan kalau orang boleh percaya.
That healing is their portion.
Dan kesembuhan itu adalah miliknya.
And stand in the place of faith.
Dan berdiri dengan iman.
And refuse to doubt.
Dan tidak akan ragu.
And know the difference between healing, miracle healing and medicine.
Dan tahu apa itu perbezaan antara penyembuhan secara mukjizat dan obat-obatan.
They will always receive miracles.
Kamu akan menerima mukjizat itu.
When I was watching that testimony this morning.
Apabila saya melihat kesaksian itu pagi
ini. I remembered another testimony that I gave while preaching in that meeting.
Dan saya teringat kesaksian yang saya berikan pada masa perjumpaan itu.
At the height of COVID.
Pada waktu puncaknya COVID.
My wife's dad.
Dan suami istri saya, ayah istri saya.
My father-in-law, yes, almost passed on.
Dia hampir meninggal.
He's in his late 70s, about to enter 80s.
Dia berumur akhir 70-an, masuk 80-an.
They called us to go.
Dan mereka memanggil kami untuk pergi.
Because he was breathless.
Karena dia sudah tidak dapat bernafas.
In fact, I first saw my wife crying and I said, "What's the problem?"
Karena saya melihat istri saya menangis, saya kata, "Apa masalahnya?"
Long story short, went home, I prayed for him.
Dan cerita dipendekkan, saya kembali ke rumah dan berdoa untuk dia.
Then they began to look for oxygen.
Dan kami mencari oksigen.
At first it looked like he's getting worse.
Dan dia kelihatan seperti bertambah teruk.
But I kept praying.
Tapi saya terus-terusan berdoa.
So he was hospitalized.
Dan dia dimasukkan dalam hospital.
You know I love hospital ministry.
Saya sangat suka pelayanan di hospital.
Because when you go to visit one person,
karena kalau kamu melawat seorang,
and every sick person sees you praying for that one person,
dan apabila orang sakit lain melihat kita berdoa untuk mereka yang lain,
they all call you, please come and pray for us, come and pray for us, come and pray for us.
Dan makin ramai yang akan memanggil kita berdoa untuk saya, berdoa untuk saya.
So in the room where my father-in-law was, there was another man.
Dalam bilik di mana bapak mertua saya itu ada seorang lelaki yang lain,
who was fighting for his life about to die.
Dan dia juga berada dalam keadaan yang nazak.
He was on oxygen.
Dan dia ada di dalam bantuan oksigen.
And the wife had given up hope.
Dan istrinya sudah berputus asa.
So after praying and talking with my father-in-law,
dan apabila saya selesai berdoa untuk bapak mertua saya,
I was requested by the administrator of the hospital, can you please pray for this man?
Dan mereka meminta saya berdoa untuk lelaki itu.
Because in his family they had lost two people of COVID.
Karena dalam keluarga itu mereka sudah hilang dua orang
kena
COVID.
And there was no improvement whatsoever.
Dan orang ini tidak ada menunjukkan keadaan yang jadi baik.
They told me that his lungs had wasted away, they were all eaten by the virus.
Mereka katakan paru-parunya itu sudah hampir rosak.
And they were just waiting for the day he'll die.
Karena mereka hanya menunggu harinya saja
so
untuk
I went
pergi.
To him,
dan saya pergi kepada laki ini.
I talked to the wife.
Dan saya berkata kepada
she
istrinya.
Was crying,
dia menangis.
Given up hope.
Dia sudah berputus harap.
I prayed for that man.
Dan saya berdoa untuk laki ini.
I told them I'm coming back tomorrow.
Dan kan saya katakan saya akan datang lagi esok.
Because every day I had to visit my father-in-law.
Karena setiap hari saya melawat bapak mertua saya.
I said tomorrow I'm still coming to pray for you.
Dan saya kata esok saya akan datang berdoa untuk kamu lagi.
So I went the next day.
Dan esoknya saya pergi.
I prayed for him.
Dan berdoa untuk dia.
And I told him you're healed.
Dan saya katakan kamu sudah disembuhkan.
I told the administrator he's healed.
Dan saya katakan kepada orang di hospital dia sudah disembuhkan.
The administrator was saying, "Are you sure?" I say, "Yes, he's healed."
Dan pekerja hospital mengatakan, "Adakah kamu pasti?" Saya kata, "Ya, dia sudah disembuhkan."
When we took our father to that hospital.
Apabila kami membawa bapak mentua saya ke hospital
we
itu.
We first got bad news.
Pertamanya kami mendapat berita yang buruk.
But I told the doctors, no, you keep him here. I'm praying he's going to get out of here.
Tapi saya kata kepada dokter, biar dia di sini dan saya akan terus berdoa untuk dia.
Do you know what happened?
Kamu tahu apa yang terjadi?
By the time my father left that hospital, I think after 5 days.
Apabila masanya bapak mentua saya dapat tinggalkan hospital itu lebih kurang 5 hari.
This man had greatly improved.
Dan orang ini sudah bertambah baik.
The next week his lungs had formed back again.
Dan pada minggu yang seterusnya paru-parunya jadi bertambah
and
baik.
After 2 weeks was totally healed.
Dan dua minggu selepas itu dia sudah disembuhkan sepenuhnya.
And my father-in-law 5 days he was totally healed.
Dan bapak mertua saya 5 hari sudah disembuhkan sepenuhnya.
Because Jesus is the healing Jesus.
Karena Yesus kita adalah Yesus yang menyembuhkan.
It doesn't matter the disease.
Tidak peduli apapun penyakitnya.
Healing is our portion.
Karena kesembuhan itu adalah milik kita.
But I'm teaching you when healing takes place.
Tapi saya mengajar kamu apabila kesembuhan itu datang.
There are many times, especially during COVID, my phone was ringing almost every day.
Banyak masa, terutama masa COVID, banyak orang menelepon saya setiap hari.
And mostly from outside the country, from other nations like Malaysia, I got many friends calling me.
Dan itu adalah kebanyakannya daripada negara-negara luar.
I have a lady in KL, she almost died.
Ada seorang perempuan ini di KL dan dia hampir mati.
They're all calling for prayer.
Dan mereka memanggil saya untuk berdoa.
God is my witness. All of them were totally healed by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Tuhan menjadi saksi saya bahwa mereka semua disembuhkan oleh kuasa Roh Kudus.
When we are praying,
jadi apabila kita berdoa,
it is not to comfort you.
Adalah bukan untuk memberi kamu kata-kata yang selesa.
It's not a trial and error.
Bukan ini adalah satu percobaan.
I know divine health is my portion.
Karena kita tahu bahwa kesehatan ilahi
divine
itu adalah milik kita.
Health is your portion.
Kesehatan ilahi itu milik kamu.
But if you fall sick,
tapi apabila kita jatuh sakit,
the Bible says I'll restore health to you.
Dan firman Tuhan mengatakan saya akan beri kamu kesehatan.
I will heal all your wounds.
Saya akan menyembuhkan luka-lukamu.
God wants you well.
Karena Tuhan ingin kita
I
sehat.
I said God wants you well.
Karena Tuhan ingin kita sehat.
You have to believe that.
Kita harus percaya itu.
And learn how to manifest your healing.
Dan apabila Tuhan memberi kita manifestasi kesembuhan itu.
Most times the manifestation is miraculous.
Banyak kalinya manifestasi itu adalah satu mukjizat.
But there will be time when you need to exercise your faith to see that manifestation fully out.
Tapi setiap kali kita harus mempraktikkan iman kita untuk melihat manifestasi itu.
By standing on God's word.
Dengan berdiri atas firman Tuhan.
By declaring God's word.
Dengan mengisytiharkan firman Tuhan.
That's why you have pastors.
Itu sebabnya kita ada pastor.
When your faith is weakening.
Tapi bila iman kita semakin berkurang.
You say, "Pastor, please pray for my faith."
Kita katakan, "Pastor, doakan supaya iman saya dibangkitkan."
You see, I have many people who call me and thank me for praying for them.
Kita tahu berapa orang yang memanggil saya, bertelepon saya mengucap terima kasih kepada saya.
I tell them no, don't thank me.
Saya katakan jangan mengucap terima kasih kepada saya.
This is what I was born to do. This is my divine call.
Inilah sebabnya saya dilahirkan. Ini adalah panggilan saya.
My joy is to see people healed.
Kerja saya adalah untuk melihat orang disembuhkan.
I hate sickness just as God hates it.
Saya benci melihat kesakitan seperti Tuhan tidak ingin melihat kesakitan.
And I know there is solution in the name of Jesus.
Dan ada solusinya dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
I know there is solution in the power of God.
Ada solusinya dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
So even as we pray tonight.
Dan apabila kita berdoa pada malam ini.
I want you to open your heart.
Saya ingin kita membuka hati kita.
Whether you have a heart disease.
Sama ada kita mempunyai sakit
jantung. Have diabetes.
Ataupun
diabetes?
Kencing manis?
Hypertension?
Atau darah tinggi?
Blindness?
Atau kebutaan?
Leukemia?
Leukemia?
Whatever the disease.
Apapun penyakit itu.
You got to believe that God wants you well.
Kamu harus percaya yang Tuhan ingin kamu sembuh.
Health is your portion.
Karena kesehatan itu adalah milikmu.
And healing is your portion.
Dan kesembuhan itu adalah milikmu.
If you have anyone sick in your family.
Dan jika ada orang sakit dalam keluargamu.
Stop living a hopeless life.
Jangan hidup dalam keputusasaan.
Learn to minister to them healing.
Belajar untuk melayani mereka melalui kesembuhan.
This is not just for me or for pastors.
Ini bukan hanya untuk saya ataupun pastor.
Look at what the Bible says in Mark 16:15-17.
Lihat apa yang firman Tuhan katakan dalam Markus 16.
God knew.
Karena Tuhan tahu.
That people fall sick.
Manusia akan jatuh sakit.
And he made every believer.
Dan dia menjadikan semua orang yang percaya.
To be responsible to bring healing.
Bertanggung jawab untuk membawa kesembuhan.
Verse 16 to 17. Give me 16 to 17. 16 to 17. Let's go back to 16. 16.
16.
Verse 16. Go back. What? One verse, please.
Ayat 16.
He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. Them that do what? Believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. Verse 18. This is for believers. Verse 18, please. If you believe, these are going to take place and happen in your life. Can I have verse 18? They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick. And what shall happen to the sick? Talk to me, what shall happen to the sick?
Apa yang terjadi pada orang yang sakit?
The sick shall recover.
Yang sakit akan disembuhkan.
You can lay hands on the sick in your family, they shall recover.
Kalau kamu tumpangkan tangan kamu atas orang sakit.
If your children are sick, lay hands on them.
Kalau anak kamu sakit, tumpangkan tanganmu.
If you are sick, lay hands on yourself.
Kalau kamu sakit, tumpang tangan atas dirimu.
Because healing is your portion.
Karena kesembuhan itu adalah milikmu.
But when we gather in a meeting like this.
Tapi apabila kita berkumpul dalam kebaktian seperti
we
ini.
We have prayed.
Kita berdoa.
We have fasted.
Kita berpuasa.
We have prepared.
Kita bersedia.
The healing anointing in such meetings is greater.
Dan urapan kesembuhan itu dalam kebaktian seperti ini adalah sangat
no
hebat.
No matter the sickness, you can connect.
Apapun penyakit kita itu.
Maybe you have someone sick who's away from here.
Mungkin ada orang yang kita tahu yang sakit yang tidak ada di sini.
You can stand in their place.
Kita boleh berdiri bagi pihak mereka.
You can receive on their behalf.
Kamu boleh menerima bagi pihak mereka.
Like Philip did for his father.
Seperti yang kita lihat Philip berdiri bagi pihak bapaknya.
And that's how the father came out of a coma.
Dan bagaimana ayah itu keluar daripada koma itu?
Never accept the lies.
Jangan terima dusta.
That God heals sometimes and he doesn't heal other times.
Yang Tuhan hanya menyembuhkan kadang-kadang sahaja.
And never be disappointed.
Dan jangan menjadi kecewa.
If you prayed for someone to be healed.
Apabila kita mendoakan seorang untuk disembuhkan.
And immediately you don't see visible signs.
Tapi kita tidak melihat tanda secara serta-merta.
We walk by faith and not by sight.
Karena kita berjalan dalam iman dan bukan dengan mata.
Our faith is in God's word.
Iman kita dalam firman Tuhan.
It is not in what we see.
Bukan dengan apa yang kita lihat.
And today if you're sick.
Dan hari ini kalau kita sakit.
You shall be healed in the name of Jesus.
Kamu akan disembuhkan dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
You shall be healed in the name of Jesus.
Kamu akan disembuhkan dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
With long life.
Dengan kehidupan yang panjang.
The Lord shall satisfy you.
Tuhan akan memenuhi kehendak-Mu.
The number of your days.
Karena hari-harimu.
The Lord shall fulfill.
Karena Tuhan akan memenuhi.
You will not die before your time.
Kamu tidak akan mati sebelum waktumu.
You will not die of COVID.
Kamu tidak akan mati karena
you
COVID.
You will not die of sickness.
Kamu tidak akan mati karena sakit.
When your time to go comes.
Apabila masanya kita pergi.
You sit down and rest.
Kita akan duduk dengan rehat.
And you will go.
Dan kita akan pergi.
Shout amen if you believe
amen.
It.
Amen.
You see, I'm teaching you what I usually do in what I call healing school.
Ini saya ajarkan kamu apa yang saya selalu nyatakan dalam sekolah penyembuhan.
Healing school, I teach on how to minister healing and how to receive.
Dan dalam sekolah ini saya mengajar bagaimana untuk melayani kesembuhan dan bagaimana menerima kesembuhan.
But today in my time of prayer and meditation.
Tapi pada hari ini dalam meditasi doa saya,
God, if I come and I just pray for the sick and go away.
Tuhan, saya katakan kalau saya hanya datang mendoakan orang sakit dan pergi,
it's not good enough.
Itu tidak cukup.
People must know how to remain healthy.
Karena umat-umat Tuhan perlu tahu bagaimana kekal sehat.
And they must know how to continually receive healing when they fall sick.
Dan mereka harus tahu bagaimana untuk terus-terusan menerima kesembuhan apabila mereka jatuh sakit.
During the lockdown,
semasa lockdown itu,
we couldn't move to you.
Kami tidak dapat pergi kepada kamu.
You had to exercise your own faith.
Kita harus mempraktikkan iman kita sendiri.
And faith comes by hearing God's word.
Dan iman itu timbul daripada mendengar firman Tuhan.
So today we will be praying.
Dan hari ini kita akan berdoa.
But when we are done here today.
Dan apabila kita selesai di sini.
For the rest of your life.
Untuk hidup kamu seterusnya.
I want you to pay attention to the things I'm going to say as I'm summarizing.
Dan saya ingin kamu mendengar apa yang saya ingin katakan
you
di sini.
You shall serve the Lord. Your God.
Kamu harus melayani Tuhan Allahmu.
Make God your first priority.
Jadikan Tuhan itu keutamaan dalam hidupmu.
When you come to church and there's an opportunity to serve, please serve.
Dan apabila kamu datang gereja ada peluang untuk melayani, melayanilah.
Don't get so busy with your work.
Jangan selalu sibuk dengan kerja kita.
Don't make your job your God.
Jangan jadikan pekerjaan kita Tuhan kita.
There are people who have thought they cannot live without working.
Dan ada orang yang tidak dapat hidup tanpa bekerja.
But how did you live during the lockdown?
Tapi bagaimana kita hidup di masa lockdown itu?
The lockdown showed you that you can be locked home and you don't go to work.
Dan masa itu kita boleh mengetahui kita tidak perlu pergi bekerja dan
so
hidup di rumah.
So you must serve the Lord your God.
Dan karena itu kita harus melayani Tuhan Allahmu.
Make God your priority.
Jadikan Tuhan itu keutamaan kita.
Use your talent, use your skill, use your time and your resources to serve God.
Ya, gunakan talenta kita dan masa dan sumber kita untuk melayani Tuhan.
That is very important.
Itu adalah sangat penting.
When you serve God,
karena bila kita melayani
expect
Tuhan,
expect divine health.
Kita akan mendapati kesehatan ilahi.
And two,
dan kedua,
get God's word into your heart.
Dan masukkan firman Tuhan itu dalam hatimu.
God's word is medicine.
Karena firman Tuhan itu adalah ubat.
Put it in your heart and speak it through your mouth.
Masukkan itu dalam hatimu dan katakan itu dari mulutmu.
Declare healing upon your life.
Istiharkan kesembuhan dalam hidupmu.
Speak well about your life.
Katakan yang baik di atas kehidupanmu.
The Bible says a wholesome tongue is medicine.
Dan firman kata Tuhan mengatakan bahwa lidah kita itu adalah ubat. obat.
There are many people who are sick because of their words.
Karena ramai orang yang sakit karena perkataan mulut mereka.
They say words like, "I'm so old, I have this old man sickness."
Karena ramai orang mengatakan saya sangat tua, saya ada penyakit orang tua.
I'm coming from our family. In our family, we have this genetic disease.
Dan kita katakan, oh keluarga saya ada penyakit genetik ini.
Which family is that?
Keluarga mana itu?
You came from there.
Mana keluarga yang kamu datang?
Now you are in the family of God.
Karena kamu sekarang dalam keluarga Tuhan.
The blood of Jesus in that family is pure blood.
Karena darah Yesus di atas keluarga itu adalah darah yang.
There's no genetic disease in the blood of Jesus.
Tidak ada penyakit genetik dalam darah
amen.
Yesus. Amen.
So don't say in our family we are sick lah. No.
Jadi jangan katakan ada penyakit keturunan dalam keluarga kita.
Use your tongue well.
Gunakan lidah kita dengan sebaiknya.
Always use the word of God about your body. Use the tongue to speak the word of upon your body.
Gunakan lidah kita memperkatakan firman Tuhan ke atas kehidupan kita.
You declare I am healthy.
Katakan saya adalah
Come
sehat.
Come on, declare it with me. Say I am healthy.
Istiharkan saya sehat.
Say there's no disease in my body.
Tidak ada penyakit dalam tubuh
By
badanku.
By Christ's stripes I was healed.
Dengan bilur Yesus saya disembuhkan.
When you keep saying that,
apabila kita terus-terusan katakan itu,
you will enjoy health.
Kita akan dapat merasakan
Yesterday
kesehatan.
Yesterday I told you don't own disease.
Saya katakan jangan kamu mengambil sakit itu.
This my asthma.
Katakan, oh ini adalah asma saya.
You know I have. You don't have.
Kita selalu katakan saya ada.
You don't
ada.
Have disease.
Kita tidak ada penyakit.
You don't have disease.
Kita tidak ada penyakit.
Now you're saying, Pastor, what should I say?
Kamu kata pastor bagaimanalah harus
don't
saya katakan?
Don't say my disease.
Jangan katakan penyakit
don't
saya.
Don't say my cancer.
Jangan katakan kanker
you
saya.
You can say cancer is attacking my body.
Kita katakan kanker itu menyerang tubuh saya.
Are you getting the point? Or you can even say there is cancer in my body.
Dan kita katakan ada kanker di dalam tubuh badan saya.
Because you are not your body.
Karena kamu bukan tubuh kamu bukan milikmu.
Your body is a suitcase.
Karena tubuh ini hanya adalah satu luaran saja.
You are a spirit.
Karena sekarang kita adalah roh.
And your body is the outside court.
Dan tubuh kita ini hanya ada di luar saja.
So when sickness comes from outside,
dan apabila kesakitan menyerang dari luar,
you is inside.
Karena tubuh kamu adalah di dalam.
You can notice that there is sickness in my outside.
Dan sakit itu adalah di luar.
And command it to go.
Dan arahkan dia untuk keluar.
But when you say I have sickness,
tapi apabila kita katakan saya ada sakit,
do you know who is the I? Do you know who is I?
Katakan siapakah mata atau melihat?
That I is your spirit.
Oh, karena yang melihat itu adalah roh
so
kamu.
So you're using your spirit to invite sickness from outside, and you own it.
Nah, maksudnya kamu menggunakan roh kamu itu mempelawakan kesakitan dalam tubuh badanmu.
Don't own sickness.
Jangan mengambil sakit itu.
Help me tell your neighbor you don't have sickness.
Dan saya katakan kepada kamu,
come on, tell your neighbor you don't have sickness.
Kamu tidak ada sakit.
You can feel sick.
Kita dapat merasakan sakit.
Because feeling is in the body.
Karena perasaan itu ada dalam tubuh badan kita.
Sickness can attack your body.
Karena sakit itu boleh menyerang
But
tubuh
don't
kita.
Say my sickness.
Tapi jangan katakan sakit saya.
You know I walk with this inhaler. You know I have asthma.
Kita selalu kata saya berjalan dengan inhaler ini karena saya ada asma.
No, you don't have.
Tapi kamu tidak ada.
You don't have.
Kamu tidak ada.
You must keep your body in health.
Kamu harus menjaga tubuh badan kamu dan kesehatan.
The Bible says, glorify God with your body.
Firman Tuhan katakan muliakan Tuhan Allahmu dengan tubuh badanmu.
The Bible says you are not your own.
Karena firman Tuhan katakan kamu bukan milik kamu.
You are bought with a price.
Karena kamu telah dibeli dengan.
So possess your body in health.
Dan kita harus menjaga tubuh badan kita dalam kesehatan.
God wants you well.
Karena Tuhan ingin kita baik.
It's only people who are well who are strong.
Karena orang yang sehat itu adalah orang yang kuat.
They are the ones who will serve Him.
Mereka lah orang yang melayani Dia.
They are the ones who will go to preach the gospel.
Mereka yang pergi memberitakan firman
It's
Tuhan.
It's only people who are well who stand and pray.
Karena orang yang sehat itulah yang datang berdoa.
So when you keep yourself healthy,
dan kalau kita menjaga kesehatan kita,
you are doing the will of God.
Kita melakukan kehendak Tuhan.
So I've said three things. Don't forget them.
Ada tiga perkara yang saya katakan.
Number one, serve God.
Pertama, layanilah Tuhan Allahmu.
Number two, keep God's word in your heart and speak it over your body.
Yang kedua, peliharalah firman Tuhan itu dalam hati kita dan istiharkan dengan
number
mulut kita.
Number three, use your tongue rightly.
Dan yang ketiga, gunakan lidah kita dengan betul.
You see, I can say lots of stuff.
Saya boleh katakan banyak perkara.
But I want to encourage you, get those books there.
Tapi saya ingin katakan belilah buku-buku
almost
itu.
Almost in every book I put a testimony.
Karena dalam setiap buku itu ada kesaksian.
Much of what I'm saying, I put it in a book called Principles of Divine Health and Healing.
Banyak yang saya katakan sini dalam buku saya itu Divine Health and Healing.
Which ran out, I no longer have them. I have to reprint them.
Sudah habis dijual.
But get how to receive and retain your healing.
Tapi kita harus belajar bagaimana untuk menerima dan mengekalkan kesembuhan itu.
Get the Holy Spirit.
Karena Roh Kudus
will teach you how.
Akan mengajar kita bagaimana.
To operate in the power of the Spirit.
Untuk beroperasi dalam kuasa Roh Kudus.
So that is for health.
Karena itu adalah untuk kesehatan.
For healing.
Dan untuk kesembuhan.
Believe that God wants you well.
Percaya bahwa Tuhan ingin kamu sembuh.
Every time we pray for you.
Setiap kali kami mendoakan kamu.
Don't look for your sickness.
Jangan mencari kesakitan kamu itu.
Look for your healing.
Cari kesembuhan kamu.
Many times we pray for people.
Banyak kali saya berdoa untuk orang.
And you tell them, how do you feel now?
Dan saya kata bagaimana perasaan kamu sekarang?
And you look at them.
Dan kamu melihat mereka.
They are not looking for a change that has taken place.
Dan mereka tidak mencari perubahan yang sudah berlaku.
They are looking for the symptoms and the pain.
Tapi mereka mencari simptom-simptom penyakit itu.
They say things like this.
Dan mereka katakan seperti ini.
There's still some little pain.
Ada masih lagi sakit di sini.
That's unbelief.
Itu adalah ketidakpercayaan.
They would have said there is a great change.
Tapi jarang mengatakan ada perubahan yang besar.
But instead they are saying there's some little pain.
Tapi mereka katakan ada lagi sedikit penyakit.
They are looking for pain. They are not looking for the change.
Tapi mereka mencari kesakitan itu tidak mencari perubahan itu.
Any change that takes place in your body after prayer.
Setiap perubahan yang terjadi dalam tubuh badan kamu setelah berdoa
is a manifestation of healing.
Adalah manifestasi kesembuhan.
So look for that change.
Dan maka itu kita harus mencari perubahan itu.
The moment you notice that change.
Kita harus perasaan akan perubahan itu.
It doesn't matter the little you're still feeling.
Dia tidak peduli walaupun kita masih merasa sedikit lagi sakit.
Praise God.
Puji Tuhan.
Worship God.
Muliakan Tuhan.
Thank God.
Beri kesyukuran pada Tuhan.
Because that is a sign that the healing is manifesting.
Karena itu adalah tanda-tanda kesembuhan itu sudah dimanifestasikan. Amen.
Amen. And then when we pray,
dan apabila kita berdoa,
believe,
percaya,
immediately believe,
serta merta percaya,
then you will see,
yang kamu akan melihat.
So you believe,
yang kamu percaya,
and you receive,
kamu menerima.
You believe,
kamu percaya,
and you receive,
dan kamu menerima.
Then after look for healing,
dan lepas itu carilah kesembuhan itu.
Number three and very importantly,
yang nomor tiga adalah sangat penting.
Learn to testify.
Belajar untuk menyaksikan
Don't
itu.
Be quiet.
Jangan duduk diam saja.
Every time Jesus healed somebody,
setiap kali Tuhan Yesus menyembuhkan seseorang,
He told them, "Go and tell people how much the Lord has done for you."
Dia katakan, "Pergilah dan nyatakan apa yang Tuhan telah lakukan kepadamu."
One time Jesus was walking.
Pada satu masa Yesus berjalan.
And this woman came behind and touched him.
Dan seorang datang dan menyentuh dia.
She was healed.
Dan dia disembuhkan.
But Jesus stopped.
Tapi Yesus berhenti
and demanded to see.
Dan dia ingin melihat
who had touched him.
Siapa yang telah menyentuh dia?
Because he wanted her to testify.
Karena dia ingin perempuan itu untuk memberi kesaksian.
When she came.
Dan apabila dia datang,
he told her, "Daughter,
dan yang mengatakan anakku,
your faith has made you whole."
Imanmu telah menyembuhkanmu.
There are people who fear to testify.
Tapi ada orang yang takut untuk beri kesaksian.
I prayed for people who say, no, for me, don't take my testimony, don't record me on video.
Dan ada orang mengatakan jangan ambil kesaksian saja, rekodkan saya di video.
Don't take even my picture.
Jangan ambil gambar saya.
You can't sustain healing.
Kamu tidak dapat mengekalkan kesembuhan.
We must tell how God has touched you.
Kita mesti beritahu bagaimana Tuhan telah menyentuh kamu.
We must spread the good news to everyone.
Kita mesti nyatakan kabar baik itu pada semua orang.
Do you know how I came to Kuching?
Kamu tahu bagaimana saya datang ke Kuching?
One brother who was healed in one of my meetings.
Ada seorang lelaki ini sudah disembuhkan dalam perjumpaan kami saya.
One day I was talking to Pastor Wong and told Pastor Wong about me.
Dan dia menyatakan Pastor Wong tentang saya.
There was another family there from Kuching, but that time they were in KL.
Dan ada lagi satu keluarga yang dari Kuching tapi pada masa itu
they
di KL.
They came to the hotel where I was staying. I prayed for them. They were healed.
Dan mereka datang ke hotel mana saya tinggal dan saya berdoa dan mereka disembuhkan.
And they came here. They told another pastor.
Dan dia mereka kembali ke Kuching dan menyatakan pada pastor yang lain.
As people testify.
Dan apabila orang terus memberi kesaksian.
One comes from one to another.
Daripada satu orang ke satu orang yang lain.
Jesus is glorified.
Yesus dimuliakan.
And many are blessed.
Dan banyak orang diberkat.
Today I received a message
dan
on my phone.
Hari ini saya menerima message di telepon saya.
A lady wrote to me from Singapore.
Ada seorang perempuan yang menulis dari Singapura.
And she told me I'm excited. I'm waiting for you next week.
Dan dia katakan saya rasa teruja dan menunggu kamu minggu
Why?
Depan.
Why? Because they went around and advertised the meetings I'm having next week.
Ya, karena perjumpaan untuk minggu depan itu sudah diadvertisekan.
This lady has been in one of my meetings before.
Dan perempuan ini pernah menghadiri kebaktian saya sebelum ini.
She told me, I want you when you come, please pray for my husband.
Dan dia kata, apabila kamu datang, saya ingin kamu mendoakan suami saya.
The husband has around 6 heart arteries blocked.
Dan kena suami itu ada blok arterinya.
And he's supposed to go through surgery.
Dan dia perlu melalui pembedahan.
So I looked at the need she was expressing to me, asking me, please get time and go to the hospital.
Dan saya melihat keperluan dia apabila menyatakan pada datanglah ke hospital.
I told her I'll pray for him and I'll go to the hospital also.
Dan saya katakan saya akan mendoakan dia dan juga akan pergi ke hospital.
But how did she know?
Tapi dia tidak tahu.
Someone told her.
Bagaimana dia tahu? Karena ada orang yang memberitahu dia.
When God heals you and you don't testify.
Jadi apabila Tuhan menyembuh kamu dan tidak memberi kesaksian.
You're being selfish.
Kamu adalah mementingkan diri
you're
sendiri.
You're not giving glory to God.
Kamu tidak memberi kemuliaan untuk Tuhan.
And you might miss or lose your miracle.
Kamu akan kehilangan kemungkinan akan hilang mujizat
so
itu.
So the time we say, if you have a testimony, come. Don't go. Don't be shy. Come and tell what God has done for you.
Dan apabila Tuhan telah menyembuh kamu, kamu harus datang dan memberi kesaksian.
That's how to receive healing.
Itulah caranya untuk menerima kesembuhan.
I've never been in a healing meeting where I didn't testify.
Saya tidak pernah berada dalam kebaktian penyembuhan di mana tidak ada kesaksian.
So when we pray for you,
dan apabila kamu mendoa, saya mendoakan kamu.
I want you to be ready to testify.
Saya ingin kamu bersedia untuk memberi kesaksian.
If there's no time and you go home.
Kalau tidak ada masa dan kamu pulang ke rumah,
send your testimony to pastor if you're a member of this church.
Kamu berikan kesaksian kepada Pastor Wong kalau kamu member gereja ini.
If you're not a member of this church and you got a flyer, type and write using that flyer telling them I got a miracle from the meeting you hosted.
Dan kalau kamu bukan ahli gereja ini, tuliskan itu dalam flyer itu mengatakan kamu mendapat mujizat daripada kebaktian ini.
Because when you testify,
karena apabila kamu menyaksikan,
that healing is actualized.
Penyembuhan itu terus
testify,
apabila kamu beri kesaksian, kesembuhan itu disempurnakan.
Haleluya. Let's rise up on our
mari kita
right
semua bangkit
and talk to God.
Dan kita berbicara pada Tuhan.
Thank him for health and healing. You deserve the glory.
You deserve the glory and the honor. Oh,
put your hand on that part that is painful, where there is pain.
Letakkan tangan di mana sakit itu di badan
kamu. Put your hand on the part where there's pain and close your eyes.
Letak tangan di tempat yang sakit dan tutup mata kamu.
And close your eyes. Whoever is sick, wherever you are, make sure you are either on the first line or second line. Put your hand and close your eyes.
Setiap yang berdiri di hadapan, yang pertama dan kedua, tutup mata kita.
In the name of the Lord Jesus, I take authority over that pain, over that infection. I take authority over every infirmity, abnormality. I come against that disease. Therefore, I command you out of their bodies. Loose them now. Get out of their bodies. Out of their hands, their shoulders, their stomach, their heads, out of their backs, their chest, in the name of Jesus, out of every organ, by the power of the Almighty God. I rebuke pain now. I rebuke cancer. I rebuke diabetes in the name of the Lord Jesus. I command you out, out, loose each and every one of them. Loose each and every one of them. Set that out right now. By the power of the Almighty God. And right now receive your healing. Be made well. Be made whole. Lift your hands wherever you are. Lift both hands now. Those
angkat
of you.
Tangan kita.
Remove
angkat
your hand from
kita.
That part. Lift them high. Lift them high.
Angkat
as you receive your healing.
Angkat kedua tangan kita.
Receive your healing now.
Terima kesembuhan.
Receive your healing now. Receive your healing now. Receive your healing
terima
now.
Kesembuhan.
Receive your
terima
healing
kesembuhan,
now.
Kesembuhan, Tuhan.
Receive your healing right now. Receive your healing now. In the name of Jesus, receive that healing. Receive it now. Receive by the power of God. Receive by the power of God. Receive in Jesus' name. Receive in Jesus' name. Receive right now by the power of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Receive. Receive right now. Receive, receive. Totally healed. In the name of Jesus, totally healed by the power of God, healed in Jesus. Take it now. Receive, receive. Free from pain, free from oppression. In the name of Jesus, receive. I release healing all over your body by the power of the Almighty God. In the name of Jesus, receive your healing. Receive your healing now. Receive it now. By the power of God, receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Receive, receive it. Receive it, receive it, receive it. Receive it, receive it, receive it. Be healed now, be healed now. Be made whole, be made whole, be made whole. Yes, all over your body, all over your body. Whole, don't stop him, just hold him, just hold him. Whole, be made whole in Jesus' name. By the power of the Almighty God.
I had a serious accident in 91.
You had what?
I had a serious accident in 91.
Uh-huh.
It took me 18 months to learn to walk again.
So how are you feeling now after prayer?
The pain that I experienced in my shoulder and back has lessened quite considerably.
Amen. Clap your hands to Jesus. A serious accident in 91. A serious accident in 91 had lots of pain in the shoulder and the back. It's reduced considerably.
I feel my neck is quite well already. Just now very pain.
You had too much pain in the neck,
no,
but right now already well. Come on, shout hallelujah. I said shout hallelujah.
Just now I feel my back, my head very bad.
You had pain in the neck?
The neck, now it's okay, and then my back pain also
the same thing. Okay now, he had neck and back pain, they are all healed. Shout amen. Just lift your hands. Lift your hands. Father, in Jesus' name, every yoke of oppression is broken off his life. So I minister total and complete wellness. Take it now. Clap your hands to Jesus. You had pain in the shoulder.
Yeah, but now I feel relieved.
Wow, come on, shout hallelujah. What was the cause of the pain?
Sorry?
What was the cause of the pain?
Punca sakit.
I'm not sure.
So how long have you had that pain?
Almost 1 month.
1 month, but now healed. Come on, shout hallelujah.
Yes,
is I have my back pain here for 21 years, and I want to declare and proclaim that I'm totally healed tonight, especially after I listen to your preaching tonight.
Yes. Amen. Glory to God.
Yes.
我是扁头痛了，然后整十年。上上哦。从我刚才来的时候还是头很晕很晕的。Okay. She's healed from migraine. How long has she had this?
10 years
migraine has just been healed. Come on, shout hallelujah.
Having pain on my head, migraine, and also half of the body. Also, I feel very painful. Yesterday, my blood pressure very high. I was admitted to the emergency.
Yesterday, why you admitted the emergency yesterday?
Because of my blood pressure, hypertension, 193 over 122. I almost got a stroke, doctor said. And then I have no. And then I almost give up in life. I said I should have ended my life. I said like that. So now today, I thank God for this opportunity to come here because I feel so lighter,
Hallelujah.
Thank you so much. Amen.
You're healed in the name of Jesus. I break hypertension. I come against every spirit of death and destruction out of her life. Out. She's free. She had ovarian cancer.
Yes. Yeah. And then before we came here, all this
microphone,
while she was on morphine.
Okay.
And then after taking that, you know, she cannot stand the pain. So before we came here, she was in pain. So after praying just now, then she said she don't feel the pain anymore.
Hallelujah. How long did she have the ovarian cancer?
Sorry.
How long? Did she have?
Since July last year.
And how long has she been on morphine?
She was went for this radiotherapy and chemotherapy until it just completed it last month. Yes.
So when she came here, she had pain.
Yes.
But after prayer, she doesn't feel pain.
Yes.
Glory to God.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
Oh.
I had COVID twice.
Okay.
And after that, I had like one pain, nerve blockage.
Speak in the microphone. You had?
I had one pain.
Bone pain?
Yeah.
Okay.
And nerve blockage.
Okay.
Then I had very bad insomnia.
Okay.
But after the prayer, it's like a flexible.
Hallelujah. The stiffness is gone. And the what? Speak in the microphone. I'm not hearing. And the what?
I have very bad knee pain.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I think it's the nerve blockage. Yeah, thanks for prayer, Pastor.
Glory to God. Shout hallelujah. Survivor of breast cancer, had COVID twice. Lift your hands. That spirit of sickness and oppression, I command it out. Leave this lady. Never return. In the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus makes you whole from the top of your head to the sole of your feet. Your bones, your back, your chest, your knees, your legs, every organ inside out. Never return. This is impartation for grace.
Ini adalah impartasi.
So close your eyes and lift your hands.
Tutup mata kamu, angkat tanganmu.
Speak in other tongues.
Berbahasa roh.
Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Bapa dalam nama Yesus.
I release the grace for healing.
Saya berikan kuasa roh.
I release the fire for healing.
Anugerah kuasa penyembuhan.
Upon your children now.
Atas anak-anakmu ini.
As I lay hands upon them.
Apabila saya menumpang tangan saya.
Let that grace come upon them strong.
Biarlah kasih karunia itu turunkan
mereka. Let them be charged up and strengthened.
Biar mereka diperkuatkan.
Let them take healing to the nations.
Dan mereka membawa pelayanan kesembuhan kepada orang lain.
In the name of Jesus.
Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
Marashaka paradosha karamai. Receive, take that anointing. 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 Take that anointing in the name of Jesus. Take that anointing. Take that anointing. Take that anointing. Receive it. All over you now. Impartation for healing. Impartation for healing. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Marashoko Borado City. Take that healing. Take that anointing. Take that anointing. Oh, Besa. Take that anointing. Take that anointing. Marashekerede Shakabaha. Marashekerea Taramanderea. Receive that. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Where the guys? Receive it. Take it now. Receive that anointing. Receive that anointing. Receive that anointing. Take that anointing. Receive. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive. Take that anointing. Sit her down. Receive it. Take that anointing. In the name of Jesus. Receive. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it right now by the power of your mighty God. Get out of my way. Receive it. Receive it now. Take that anointing. Catch us, get out of my way, please. Receive it. Receive it now. 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 Receive it. Receive. Take it now. Marasho korodulu sarama. Receive it now. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus. Grace for healing. Take it. Receive it. Receive it. You're the name above all. The guys who are on the second line, come.
You are worthy of all.
Hurry, the guys, I didn't pray for who are on the second line. Come. Those who are on the second line, who are catching, come for prayer. Oh, you're the name. Lift your hands. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus. Fresh grace upon you. Fresh grace in the name of Jesus for healing. Receive it. Receive it by the power of God. Receive it. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in Jesus' name.
We have set up a theological education fund. We want to have some funds ready to send young people to go to Bible schools and to serve God on a full-time basis. Our goal is to raise 80,000 ringgit in 1 year. You can make a one-off donation or give monthly, bi-monthly, or quarterly. The church account number will be shown after the announcement. When you give, you must indicate to our treasurer that it is for theological education fund. Otherwise, it will get mixed up with the tithes and offerings. Our treasurer is Mr. Teo Tong Teck. His telephone number is 016-890-0850 and his email is ttteck@gmail.com. let me say a prayer of blessing for you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. May you be like a tree planted by the stream. May your leaves always be green, and may you always be fruitful. May He give you the desire of your heart and make all your plans succeed. May He meet all your needs according to the riches of His glory in Christ Jesus. May He give you an abundant measure of peace, love, and mercy. May His hands always guide and sustain you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.